Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to take a quick look at Adobe Firefly. It's still in beta at the moment, but it's actually putting out some pretty good results. So today we're going to be looking at the text to image generator. So essentially it works like Midjourney and Stable Diffusion, but you've got an actually usable, easy to follow UI, so a user interface. So we're going to jump straight in. So if you've got access to the beta, just jump into text to image and click generate. Okay, so on this screen, we're going to enter in our prompt. So at the moment it's English only and it's quite sensitive, so if you enter anything sort of remotely from a different language, so Spanish names, German names, etc., causes some issues. So we're going to start with this prompt here: a portrait of a blonde woman standing on a street in a cyberpunk city wearing futuristic clothes, hyper-realistic detailed environment. So they're going to be some weighted influences. So once you've done that, click generate. This will generate four base images, so if you like any of those already and you want to continue with them, just click options and go use as reference image. However, for most people, it's going to be highly unlikely that you're going to get something great from the get-go. The next thing you're going to do is adjust your aspect ratio. So we're going to change to widescreen 16:9, just a preference of mine. You can use whatever you like. Okay, after you've done that, we have another list of options here. So we're going to go to content type and select photo. However, I like this image here already. It's quite good. So I'm going to set as a reference image just to keep it. Then we will change to photo. As you can see, we've got a reference slider here. So this allows us to weight the image. So if we want it weighted more heavily to the reference image, we will slide it this way. And if we want it more open to change and to the prompt, we're going to slide it over to the other side. So this is what we've got so far. As you can see, they're kind of similar and weighted that way. If we go back over here to the prompt, it will weight the image less towards the reference. This is similar to the way that Midjourney and Stable Diffusion work. However, Adobe has put it onto a slider, which makes it way more easier than using weighted numbers. So this is definitely a great change. So as I said, we're going to change over to photo. Even though our image was generated in art, still going to use that reference image and change it to a photorealistic style. Okay, so now we're in photo. We're going to go back to our reference image, slide it across a little bit more because I did like that. So we're going to try and get it to look more like that. Okay, already working. So again, this one is coming along really well. So we're going to update our reference to this one. Now, updating your reference image regularly is a great way to fine tune your product. So I'd recommend doing this as often as possible, as often as you get something good. So as you can see, we've got some new variables here, still in the same style. So again, if you want something specific, just go in and set as a new reference. But I quite like where we're heading at the moment with our current reference image. So we're going to go over to styles here and we're going to go set it to all. And we're going to have a quick look at the styles. So these are the base ones. These are kind of like weighting your image in Midjourney or Stable Diffusion. So we're already in cyberpunk. So we're going to go cyberpunk as a weighted option. We're going to go hyper-realistic as another weighted option, and we're going to leave it at that. Okay, so we're going to minimize styles and go to color and tone, lighting and composition. So here we have some different options. So I want to go vibrant color for our image, lighting, let's go dramatic lighting. Quite a few options here, but we're going to go dramatic lighting. And we are going to leave the option set to none for this. As you can see, there's different angles you can change here, but for now, none seems to be working, and that's the style that I want. So now we've got our weighted options put in here. We're going to click generate. Okay, so we're getting quite good style options here. A little bit of variance from our original, so our slider is working quite well. I'm going to refresh a few times and see what else we get. We might be able to update our reference image again. Okay, so it's going to start throwing in random eyes. So this happens quite often with most of these AI art generators. They do some weird stuff with eyes. This one's not as bad, but you can see it as well. So just refresh past those. Okay, so we're back on track with some normal looking eyes, but we've got weird faces. So let's just adjust the slider a little bit further to our reference because that was looking pretty good to start with. Okay, things are looking pretty good here, I think. That one's not too bad, and this one's not too bad, so quite a lot of difference when you zoom in. So the eyes here are a bit more wonky. I would say that one's quite good. So 2 and 4 are reasonable. So I'm going to go ahead and download 4. So to download an image, just click the download option. It will download it and tag it and also put a watermark on it. So just to have a look at it, that's what it's going to look like. And that's the watermark there. It's easy enough to get rid of if you know what you're doing in Photoshop or something similar. So now we'll just check on the resolution. So just right click, where's properties? Okay, it's not going to let me do it. So let's open in File Explorer, right click, properties. So we're looking at an image that is 1792 by 1024, 96 DPI and 24 bit depth. So not too bad for a standard image for free out of Adobe Firefly. So that's zooming in a bit. It's quite realistic, quite a great looking picture. So what most people will do now is to get the final results is they'll jump into Photoshop, GIMP or something else, and then they will just Photoshop the rest of the image. So they'll go in, they'll fix the eyes up a little bit, fix the skin textures, fix up any of the edges that aren't well, and that's how they're getting such impressive results. But this here is pretty much perfect for how much effort we've put in. So we've used a simple tag. We've changed a few little options here to weight the image. So we'll just do a couple more things and then we'll wrap this video up. So we're going to change the dramatic lighting to backlighting. We're going to change the content type to none. See what results we get. Okay, so we've had some small changes here. Actually, all four of these images are quite good. Face has changed a little bit, but nothing too noticeable. Okay, that pretty much wraps up this guide. I hope you found it useful. I hope you do get the chance to jump into Adobe Firefly and test out the beta. It's pretty cool, pretty fun, and using it is a lot easier than using Midjourney and Stable Diffusion. You don't have as much trouble organizing your weights, setting out your prompts and everything to get your final results. Admittedly, you do probably get better results out of both of those at the time being, but Firefly's only been out for a short time, so I expect them to expand on everything dramatically. And I do think they'll become one of the big players in the game. So Midjourney and Stable Diffusion are going to have some pretty stiff competition ahead. Anyway, that wraps up this guide. Thanks for watching as usual. I hope you found this content interesting. And as always, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in another video.